The smell of sulfur fills the air. But this is not pollution. This is the smell and sound of a system that's cleaning up pollution, specifically acid mine drainage, or AMD, a common byproduct of coal mining. These two needle-like devices, known as venturis, spatter out about 600 gallons each of acidic water every minute.
This water can be treated two ways. You can add chemical to it to remove the iron, or removing the iron through passive wetlands and ponds.
This site near Fordstown, Pennsylvania, represents the possibilities of what scientists can do using a new software package from the Office of Surface Mining, Reclamation, and Enforcement, and the U.S. Geological Survey. To understand the software's importance, we have to go back to 1998, when water from an old underground mine broke through rock and spilled into a nearby trout stream.
Which had iron-laden water going the whole way down the stream.
And what happened to the fish and the wildlife?
It wasn't good.
Pennsylvania quickly responded to the breakthrough using active chemical treatment, but the price was high.
The chemical costs were upwards of $20,000 a month, and they had no long-term funding source.
After collecting samples, Means used AMDTreat, OSM's software package that allows professional hydrologists to model the most economic and effective method to remove the pollution. Means determined the state could save about $250,000 each year if it used passive treatment like the venturis instead of adding chemicals.
The new enhancement in AMDTreat is perfect for modeling and estimating costs for this type of water. Is specifically designed to help model these costs.
While it cost about $500,000 to build the 13-acre settling ponds, the cost was offset in about 2 years, and the savings over time are significant because treatment will go on in perpetuity. Finding enough space for the treatment site was a challenge. Pennsylvania approached the owners of the 13-acre lot, asking if they would help in the effort to clean up the pollution. Their names were Mary Beth and Kim Rauch.
She wanted more than just a treatment pond. She wanted to enhance other values such as wetland values, and then she brought up this idea that we wouldn't have thought of, that this might and should be a great destination for environmental classes for our local schools.
But before the work was completed, Mary Beth Rauch died. To commemorate the ongoing nature of the Rauch's donation, the state built a pavilion for classroom visits, and a plaque honors her commitment to the environment and education.
There was a person that made this happen. That was Mary Beth Rauch. Thankfully, AMDTreat gave us the tools to make it cost effective.
The software is free to download from the Office of Surface Mining, and earlier versions are in use worldwide in more than 100 countries. For the U.S. Department of the Interior and the Office of Surface Mining, I'm Chris Holmes.